Kia ora, in this video we are going to be having a look at Māori land via the Māori Land Court website. All of these little grey dots, we're going to have a deep dive into this website. We're going to look at how to get access to the information, what sort of information is available. We're going to look up how to find names, how to find trustees, how to find shares, how to find the actual documents that have gone through the Māori Land Court. We're going to go through all of that information that is available free of charge to you. So if this is something that you've been interested in for a while, please hang around for the next few minutes while we have a look at it. But first, before we get into it, I want to make mention of my new membership, the Manaaki membership. If you've been following this page for a while, if you've been a supporter for a while, you can now join an exclusive membership. If you jump over to my page here, click up the top and the first link, join the Manaaki membership. For less than a cup of coffee per month, you can join. $3.99, $4 a month you can join. You get a loyalty badge, you get access to custom emojis, and you get a whole access to a whole bunch of members only content. So if that sounds like something that you're interested in, please jump over there and have a look at it. That's enough about me. Let's close that. Let's close this. We're going to start at Google. So if you go to Google and type in Māori land, the first link that's going to come up is Te Kimi o Whenua, Find Your Land. This is the website, and to get over to the area where we can search the map, we're going to click up here, Pātaka Whenua, our online portal. That will bring you here, steps for block search. We're going to close that, and it now brings us into this really nice, clean, Google-driven mapping interface. And as you zoom in, you will start to see all these little grey shaded blocks everywhere. There's a lot more on the North Island than there is on the South Island. That's one of the first things that jumped out at me. But each one of those blocks, each one of those little coloured in blocks, is a registered block of Māori land. So you can dive right in here. You can get right down on the detailed level and see where the alignments are. For each of the blocks, you can click up in the top right-hand corner here. Got to move my head and turn the Google satellite on as well. So if you want to have a look at this from a Google Maps perspective and see where all the land boundaries are, you can dive in and do that as well. Look, you can get in right detailed here. You can see this sort of battle axe shaped block here. This one here is a Māori owned parcel of land. So I'm going to go back to the Google Streets View, a little bit easier to see. So they're each of the blocks, and we can click on each one of them. So I'm going to pick a random one here. Look, I'm not looking at anyone in particular. I'm just going to pick, you know, close my eyes, find something on the map, maybe something around here, up here, south of Auckland. So this block here. So you can click on the block and it will bring up this little pop-up. There's a whole bunch of metadata details here, but the thing we're going to do is click on the top link. And that's going to open up essentially the profile for this block of land. So you get a nice map area. You can see all the total shares for the owners that own the shares, the area details, and some documentation details. So, and this will be the same on every block that you find. So it will click on another one, click on this one, same sort of format. So you can scroll down here, find ownership. So we click on ownership, land administration, no data, that's pretty typical. Ownership, so you can find a whole bunch of names here of individuals that are owners on these titles. You can often find whānau trust as well. And look, I'm not trying to dig in here and expose anything. This is all public information. I've just picked a random block here, so you can click through this whānau trust and see who the members of the trust are. So that's one thing that you can start off by doing, is having a click through, looking through names, looking through the trust, looking through documents. Let's go down to the South Island. Again, just picking random blocks to click through. So that is the land ownership. We can also click on documents and look through some of these documents. 1968, some of them you won't have access to. guessing all these ones. Oh, here we go. This one we've got access to. And it's actually got the PDF here of what these documents are. So what is this document? List of current owners report. So this gives all the data about the block, the management structure name, the names of the administrators, and then the names of the shareholders, whether they be individuals or a trust that's been set up, and the amount of shares that they hold. So we'll jump out of that one. So that's for a particular block of land. That's what we found. If we click on owners, click on ownership, you can generally click through trusts. And then within that trust, you'll find who's part of that trust. And you can often find some details around the documents when it was created. If we click on that. And a whole bunch of information around how the trust was set up. There's minutes here by the looks of it. I'm not going to go into too much detail on that, but that's the sort of information that you can find here, you can get access to. This is public information. I'm, again, reiterating, by no means picking on anyone in particular. I'm just picking random blocks on the map. There's also the search function over here that'll get rid of the map, so you can type in the block name if you know it. You can type in document names. You can look up different organizations, or you can look up individual ownership as well. So you've got all those options there at your disposal. So that's a really quick look at, I've got to close all this, might go back to the block map. That's a really quick look at the Māori Land Court website, how to look at all these individual blocks of land. There's a lot of information on the website itself, so I would implore you to go and have a look at that and learn a bit more about this. If it's something that you've been interested in or something you've been disengaged with and you would like to engage with it, I would highly recommend jumping on the website and learn. Kia ora.